is the moment。
两个月前，身世坎坷的 UFC 选手 Finn Balor Rumble 因他面临的经济困境而引发关注。在比赛前，户头仅剩$7，每天睡在拳馆沙发。在 UFC Vegas 73拿下首胜后， Rumble 卖掉了自己比赛的短裤和拳套，赚了$7,000。而 Rumble 没有用这$7,000改善自己的生活，而是帮在家乡津巴布韦的村子建了一个水泵，让村子居民能够享用干净的水。好莱坞巨星绰号 The Rock 的 Dwayne Johnson 在听说了 Rumble 的故事后深受感动，承诺会对 Rumble 提供帮助。日前 ，The Rock 履行了诺言。据媒体报道 ，The Rock 送了这位非洲选手一户位于迈阿密、配备齐全的公寓。The Rock 本人最近也亲自前往佛罗里达的 MMA Master 俱乐部跟 Rumble 见面，给了这位努力不懈又心地善良的选手一个大惊喜。这位在 UFC 293挑战 Israel Adesanya 的重量级冠军目前还没有定案。在传出 DDP 表示无法挑战后， Sean Strickland 在 Adesanya 指名下成为最有希望的挑战者。但在最近的一条 tweet 中， Strickland 说自己跟 Adesanya 的比赛没得到 UFC 的同意。距离 UFC 293剩下6个星期，但主赛内容都还没有确定，好像有点夸张。Strickland 是目前最适合的挑战者，会不会是他也知道这点，所以狮子大开口喊了一个 UFC 接受不了的价呢？最后的挑战者会是谁？让我们继续看下去。还记得上个月 Alex Pereira 发了一段在 Walmart 被不明人士跟踪的影片吗？影片当时造成热议，很多拳迷责怪 Walmart 有歧视顾客的嫌疑。但在昨天 UFC 291媒体日， Pereira 亲自揭晓，在 Walmart 尾随他的男子既不是店内保安，也不是疯狂的粉丝，而是一名来自 USADA 的特工。Pereira 说：“说实话，这个视频最初是开玩笑的。他很喜欢恶作剧。那天他离开家去购物 ，USADA 的人刚好来到他家，因此不得不跟着他去 Walmart。本来风向认为，因为 Pereira 是巴西人，被人跟奸非常可悲。现在总算还 Walmart 清白了。Alex Pereira 将在周末的 UFC 291 Co-Main Event 对上波兰大锤 Jan Blachowicz。与两人都交手过的重量级冠军 Israel Adesanya 对这场比赛特别感兴趣。根据经验，黑龙给出了对比赛的预测。
Me stylistically, it's an exciting matchup. I might just try and like do that early on and take away his power, his chances of striking and wear him down. Jan's definitely gonna try and take it down.He's no stupid. I think Alex will start fast. Just put that pressure on straight away. That leg kick, it's hard to reach. He's gonna throw that leg kick. Jan, gonna take his time, patience, get as much reads as he can. If Jan does what I think he's gonna do, he's gonna get caught with a left hook. So official pick, I'm gonna go Alex. So Alex by knockout.
那么你各位支持黑龙预测的结果吗？如果要在这场对决下注，你各位压哪一边呢？Wonderboy Stephen Thompson 将在周末出战跟自己打击风格类似的 Michelle Pereira。与 BMF 一一相反， Wonderboy 曾在节目上获颁媒体自制的 MMF 腰带，也就是个性最好的混蛋。在充满暴力之气的 UFC， Wonderboy 真可说是一股清流。看看他在本周赛前与对手 Michelle 见面时的画面，像见到远房亲戚一样，这条 MMF 腰带真的实至名归。而在上周末出席 UFC Fight Night 伦敦站的 MVP， 如果能跟 UFC 签约对上 Wonderboy， 将会是所有拳迷梦寐以求的对决。媒体日上被记者问到跟 MVP 交手的可能， Stephen Thompson 这样回应：
I just became friends with this guy literally like a few months ago. Like we hung out for like a whole weekend and it's like, dude, why do they want me to fight you now? Like I it's understandable, karate versus karate, right?I think obviously it would be a fun match, but he's a good dude, man. I don't want to say I would want to fight him at this point because we've grown that relationship now.
尽管 Wonder Boy 对跟 MVP 的比赛提出保留，但他也提出了跟 MVP 对战人选的建议。
You know, Ian Garry would be a great one. I think that would be a good matchup. You know, there's some other strikers out there. Shavkat, I think, would be a good one too. Venom Page brings not just the karate.To the welterweight division, but his length and he's a very tall, very lengthy guy. For a guy like him to have that karate base is very dangerous.
Kevin Holland 的全迷对即将到来的比赛担心，因为他要跟 Michael Chiesa 这个强大的摔跤手对战。但 Holland 在媒体日上说，是他自己要求打排名12的 Chiesa， 但这不代表他已经准备好面对艾文胯下的 Colby Covington。
We're gonna grapple. I mean, am I gonna KO him? I mean, absolutely. But I mean, to think that he's not gonna grab me before I KO him, I'd be fucking ridiculous. Look, I said I want to work on my wrestling in the cage against Michael Chiesa. I didn't say that my wrestling was good enough to beat Colby Covington. Me and Colby Covington get in there, I still believe I'll knock him the fuck out. But you know, he starts sniffing my dick, and it might be like that for 25 minutes. You know, so.
近况凄惨的人民冠军叶师傅 Tony Ferguson 不甩他人的质疑，认为自己正接近巅峰状态，也没考虑退休。
I feel at this point in time in my life that I'm just barely hitting my prime. I'm gonna be done when I want to be done, but I'm also gonna have to do what I have to do in order to get to where I want to get. Five fights in the title, baby.
然而赌盘也是现实的，叶师傅毫无疑问成为下狗，胜负似乎是主卡的对决组合中最没悬念。身为 Tony Ferguson 的拳迷，彩票我虽然买了 Bobby Green 这一方，但真的不忍心看到叶师傅再输了。希望叶师傅能狠狠打我的脸，打赢 Bobby Green 重登巅峰。那么你各位认为 Tony Ferguson 的胜算多高呢？周末的比赛会是夜魔的退休战吗？芭比跟奥本海默要选谁，最近是个很夯的话题。UFC 巨星 Conor McGregor 已经表达了自己的喜好，他在 IG 上发了一张他与教练 John Cavanaugh 的合照，两人坐在一辆敞篷车中。Conor 写道：“请给我们两张芭比的门票。”将在 UFC 294对上狼王的 Costa 也搭上芭比热潮，在每天发一篇梗骂狼王的更新节奏下，他昨天在 IG 设计了一款圈圈芭比，并说：“10月21号，我要带着新款的圈圈芭比送给我的侄女。”除了 UFC 291 Bellator 跟 Rising 2的联合赛也是在这周末，但是不幸的主角之一的 AJ McGee 在 Twitter 上发布了退赛声明，并分享了他膝盖的一些生动图片。
I'm sorry, but I won't be fighting this weekend in Japan. To all my Japanese fans, I'll see you guys soon. And guess what? We will be back in Japan. I promise you that. I ended up catching staph, guys. So, you know staph, it's a really bad infection, flesh eating. It'll literally put you in the hospital. I had to go to the ER. I've been on antibiotics and it's healing up well, but make sure you take a look and I'll show you guys the process of what I've been dealing with. But check it out. Yee! A couple little holes in my knee, but we're gonna come back stronger, better than ever. And y'all already know what it is. Champ shit only.
周末的各个刺激对战组合，你各位最期待哪一场呢？欢迎留言讨论，一起享受比赛吧。